All right, back to work tonight, guys and gals. About that time of day again here after all. It's Tuesday evening. It is January the 5th, 2021. My name is Joseph, and as always, welcome back to your nightly newsletter. Now, tuning in for the first time tonight, if you're here for the first time, it's great to have you with us here in the new year. My job tonight is to help us find the best trade setups for tomorrow. That's Wednesday's trading session. I got a fantastic video in store for you guys tonight. Charts are all prepped up in the background. As you can see, got the E-minis. Oh, we got the oil. And we got the gold on our radar for tomorrow. Speaking of tomorrow, markets are looking a bit top heavy tonight. Gold pushing up to new highs, oil sitting at highs, S&P sitting at highs right now. Lots of clues telling us these buyers might be in for some trouble tomorrow. Not to worry though, we'll put the entire plan together with my favorite setups for tomorrow in just a few moments. Before we jump in though and get our hands dirty on these charts for Wednesday's trading session, I just want to make sure to remind you, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. We publish this video newsletter every evening, Monday through Thursday, with our best trade ideas for the following day. So make sure you subscribe to join our channel so you don't miss our next video newsletter. And as always, if you have any questions for me tonight, drop those questions in the comment section below. I'll get them answered as soon as possible. And as always, if you tune in every evening to watch this video, if you enjoy this newsletter as much as I enjoy making it for you, I always appreciate you guys hitting that thumbs up button for me by supporting this YouTube channel. So thanks so much for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe and drop those questions if you got any questions in the comment section below. But enough of the introduction. Charts are prepped. Let's take a look at what's setting up for tomorrow's trading session. Now, of course, got the S&P, got the crude oil, and we got the gold on our radar. Everything, like I said, is feeling a little bit top-heavy right now. The S&P, of course, had a range today, but jumped up, and you can see buyers are really struggling. I'll tell you, I'd like to get short here on this S&P, but there's one thing that's really kind of holding me back right now from getting short immediately here. So I'm waiting for one more clue on the S&P. I'm going to go over that here in just a few moments. Over on the crude, right in the middle, boy, we talked about that OPEC meeting in last night's newsletter. Oil is back up to that 50 bucks a barrel level. It's now trading sideways in a range. Maybe it's a spike in channel. I'd love to be a buyer down just above this 49, but like I mentioned, these markets do look a little bit top heavy. I'll tell you right now, there's a good chance these bears get a nice strong run going back down into that range from earlier on this week. I'm watching closely around that 49.25 area. I'll talk about some setups to look for both the long side and the short side for the black gold, the Texas tea, the crude oil for tomorrow. And speaking of the gold, right, the yellow metal over on the right-hand side, gold, of course, very bullish this week. We had that weekend gap we talked about in last night's newsletter. But you'll notice, though, we're just a little bit above that trading range. Got some major areas of resistance over. I'll tell you right now, if these buyers can't keep this together here, gold could potentially have a pretty rocky ride here tomorrow. Now, we're very bullish on gold right now, so I will be looking for some buy-side opportunities. But I'll tell you, there could be some easy money to make shorting off this high and then riding it right back up again. So got a pretty good plan of attack there on the gold. I want to start first tonight, though, over on the S&P. Let's jump into the S&P 500 chart. Let's take a look at what's going on here on the E-mini. Now, the key takeaway right now on the S&P is, of course, we have this trading range. The market begins the day inside a pretty neutral, pretty balanced range. And anytime we have a range-bound market like this, we know the plan is pretty straightforward, right? Want to buy low at support, want to sell high at resistance, and keep using that range as a magnet, right? So it was what we call a range day today in our trade room here this morning. And of course, that trading range acting like a magnet. Well, you'll notice what happened, right? The market, of course, buyers bought low, sellers sold high, and then we get this late day, you know, kind of early afternoon into middle afternoon here, that strong rally going higher. Now, this, of course, pushes back into that trading range from last night's newsletter. But look where we go, right? We go nice two big legs higher, and then here's the kicker on the S&P. We pull back once, the buyers try, we pull back twice, the buyers try. That's why I said in the introduction, it definitely feels like this market could be a little bit top heavy as we go into Wednesday's trading session. The buyers are really kind of floundering here right now, trying to keep this market running higher. I've got the buyers struggling up around these resistance top highs, and I've got that range waiting down below acting as a magnet. Now, I mentioned earlier, there's one thing kind of keeping me from getting short too aggressively, and that is the strength of this move, right? Anytime we see a real strong move in one direction, we usually will anticipate a retest of that high. So I got to be a little bit careful right now because obviously the bulls have the momentum at their back right now. But I'll tell you, I'd like to get short going back down into that range and possibly completing a full-blown pendulum swing back to take out those lows tomorrow. Now, the best way to get short will probably be with one of two different setups. What I would really like to see is, I'd like to see this market come back, make one more lower low, and then what I'll do is, I'll draw a trend line off these lows, I'll pop it right up around these highs, and I'll look for that short right off the top of that channel. What this will end up being is buyers trying effectively three times, but twice below the moving average. One of the keys to these failure setups is getting below the moving average. So imagine now, right, we get the buyers trying once, buyers trying twice here, and you'll notice I'm trying to make sure I leverage an area of resistance, right, up overhead. Now, I wouldn't be upset if the market traps above that high as well, right? That would not make me upset whatsoever, but I'm looking for that trap high. I'm looking for that channel top to short back down into that trading range. This would be what we call a failure setup, right? A nested failure pattern. And we'll talk more about these as we go here. Now, we may not get that beautiful setup going short here. We may have to look for something a little bit more aggressive. Let's say, for example, the market takes a tumble going lower. I've got this channel, right, coming in off of these lows. Let's just say, for example, here we get what we call a two-try trap, right? We run lower and we look for a trap above that high. This would definitely not be as desirable as the first setup I was talking about, but this would be, it's we'll take whatever we can get here. What I'm anticipating though is as the market runs lower here, because of the strength of this move, right? We anticipate obviously buyers will try to come in and buy off of that low. If we can get the buyers coming in trying to get long off that low, the problem is I don't want to just short into that low. What I have to do is get those buyers again, have them try to get short, right? Have those bears come in and then see if those buyers can get me in with a trap so I can sell up above the top of that trading range. Now, keep in mind, both of these setups to sell short off the high, my most important target's gonna be back at the low of that trading range, right? Wanna make sure we take the bulk of our profit off at the low of that trading range, and then hold on for the ride, right? Leave a target down to that 36.72, and if we really get lucky, we can make it all the way down to that 36.62 here for tomorrow. So as the market pulls back, I'm looking for those buyers once, twice, find that right trap above that high or that two-try failure pattern, right? Or we go down, we pull back, we go lower, stay out of the range, right? And selling up above that top, right? That'd be a great trap entry as we go lower. Now, as far as if the market goes higher here, right, there's not a lot I can do here, right, without waiting for some more proof. My biggest problem I have is we're back inside this trading range from yesterday. If you recall, we had that big range from over the holiday session. And so I've got to really be careful as the market pushes to new highs. You can easily see the buyers are really struggling here. So I think what I'd like to do is basically wait for proof. Now, where do we think the buyers want to go? If we go looking overhead here, we've got our next big objective up around 37.73. So plenty of space overhead for these buyers to run. That's good news for us, but we have to make sure we get some proof first. I definitely don't want to try try to buy the breakout above these highs because of the trading range overhead. And of course, we're sitting right at that measured move. So I'm looking for one of two breakout patterns as we go higher here. One would be a 1-2-3 breakout, strong move up, hold the pullback, and then one, draw the trend line off the high, two, post trend line off the low, right? We call these 1-2-3 breakout patterns, right? So 1-2-3, hold the pullback off the moving average. Show me some proof these buyers are pushing higher and look to buy that first pullback. Remember, the first test is always the best test off the low of that new hidden channel. Another pattern I'm looking for tomorrow is what I call a two-try breakout. This one requires a little bit more strength running higher, but if I can get a strong move up, a shallow pullback, a higher high in price, I'll look for a trap below that low, and that should be a pretty reliable trade if we can get, again, got to see a nice strong pop right above that high. So again, two types of breakout patterns here. I don't want to buy into these highs right now. Show me that 1-2-3 breakout, find that high, mark that low, looking to get long off the low of that new hidden channel, or it's going to be that two try breakout pattern. These are pretty easy to see because you get these strong breakouts, these shallow pullbacks that barely pull back to the moving average. Then you see this higher high in price. Once you get that, then you know where your entry is. It's right below that low, right? Two try breakout. And again, we know where the targets are going to be above at 37.75. The last piece of this puzzle is, what if we end up going sideways back inside this range? Remember, this range at 29.5 down to that 20 area, if we happen to go sideways here and kind of get stuck inside a range up here, that will definitely give the buyers the edge. Well, they already have the edge right now, but that will solidify the buyers' control of this market. What do we do if the market goes sideways? And keep in mind, the market could easily go up and go sideways up here too, right? So consider that to be the same basic idea. But if the market starts going sideways here with this bull bias, what do we do in that situation? We find levels of support below the range, right? Trend lines, swing lines, and we combine those areas with what we call two-try failure patterns. It's very simple. We wait for a price to get below the range, get down in a support area. Again, find a prior swing, find a trend line. Sometimes we'll get some hidden, right? Some little expanding triangle levels down here. But the key is you want to find a support level below the range. Wait for those sellers to try to get short off the moving average pullback and just simply buy right into those stop losses, right? Simple as that. So if we start going sideways here, I'm looking for what we call two try failure patterns to keep the party running higher. Now, guys, we talk a lot about these failure patterns, breakout patterns, trap patterns. In fact, we cover all of these specific entry patterns in our free trading course here at School of Trade. If you want to get a deeper dive into all the entry patterns we're looking for tomorrow, lots of examples, right, of how we apply this strategy to our favorite markets, grab that free trading course. I'll put a link that pops up there in the upper right-hand corner. As part of the free trading classes, you'll learn my four favorite setups, my entire three-step strategy, and I'll send you hundreds of examples of how we apply that strategy to our favorite futures markets. I'll also send you an invite to come out and join us, right, for the trade room. So grab that link that popped up there. Grab that link. Get registered as a brand new member of our free trading course and learn all the details of these entry setups. So now we get a pretty good plan here. I'd love to get short on the S&P for tomorrow, but again, I got to respect the buyers and wait for a couple of these failure patterns to get short off the high. So S&P is looking good. Shall we keep going? Let's grab a look at the oil for tomorrow. Looking at the oil here as we go into Wednesday. Now, a lot like the S&P, the buyers have control of oil right now, but as you can see, we're looking a little bit top heavy here. And the reason I say that, the key takeaway here on the oil, we definitely have a very strong run higher here on the oil. You'll notice anytime we see a real strong move in one direction, what do we expect? We expect to see a pullback and a retest of that high, right? This type of move is what we're expecting on the S&P. That's why I'm not getting that aggressive, right, getting short on the E-mini. You'll notice, though, the buyers clearly retested their high, but look, they're not going anywhere, right? They're struggling. They're really struggling to give us any proof of any move higher. Now, I would expect these buyers to be hunting for a measured move up here, up at 50.69, right? 50.69, 50.70, 50.68, right? Give or take a few ticks up there. But they're really struggling. And so we have a very strong bull market that got their pullback. They closed their loop, as we always say in our trade room. But now, like I said earlier, it's starting to look like these buyers might be a little bit top heavy here, right? And be looking for a pullback. Now, with that pullback, you'll notice I've got my trading range drawn up here. So what I would do is I would call this a bull market into a trading range. You might even call this a bull market into a spike in channel pattern. The trading range is the most important clue as far as I'm concerned, because as we rotate off the high, as we pull back, notice what's happening. We're pulling back from above the high of that trading range. Now, we talked about this last night on the newsletter. When it comes to a range-bound market, as we just talked about on the S&P, there's a bullish bias to it into a trading range. Now, what I like to do is I like to find a support level below the range, right? Trend line, expanding, right? Expanding triangle, channel line coming up here, right? Find a little support there, wait for the price to pull back, and then simply look for a seller failure pattern, right? To buy into stop losses and use the range as a magnet, right? So that's the general idea of a bull market into a range. But there's one small detail that we're missing here on this oil example, and that is the fact that we're not just starting off inside the range, we're starting off above the range. And this is where things get a little difficult, because as the market pulls back now, we still want to find that level of support below us. But now here's the problem. Now we're really starting to look more bearish, right? These are two very similar situations, but very, very different. Why? Because the second scenario here, we're rotating off the high. So in these types of situations, I have to be a little more conservative. I can't be too aggressive. I have to look for the bears to try twice now, and then I can look for the buy going higher. And I think that makes sense, right? You're concerned about the momentum of the bears. So instead of getting real aggressive and just buying the stop losses like I normally would, I have to kind of back it out a little bit and let the bears try a few times with a slightly more patient entry setup. We call a nested variation of our failure pattern. Now, as you can imagine too, the bears may take this thing lower, right? A lot of times these kind of, again, we call them rotation off the high. Anytime we see that, there's likely this might turn into a 1-2-3 reversal. And honestly, right, I love it when it does that, because what I'll do is I'll mark up that low, I'll mark up that high, and I'll find that new hidden channel and look for that short off the high. So as you can see, there's a lot of potential here as we go into this oil session for tomorrow, right? We can definitely see the bulls have it. We can see the trading range up there, and we can see we're rotating off that high. What we can also tell is as we come down, I've got some great support down here. In fact, I like the fact that this is going to be the base of that spike in channel. Anytime we have a spike in channel on the chart, right, we know that the base of that channel is going to be a really big spot for buyers to come in. The problem is, though, it's going to be a really deep pullback, and that momentum is going to be a concern. Now, there is a chance here these bears may hold, and to get short or to get long up here, I've really got to be careful, right, with a trap low. So there is a chance these buyers may hold the low of this channel. We're obviously bullish right now, so buyers may get a little bit aggressive up here. But I'll tell you, this is a really tough area to justify being a buyer. You're right into that major top at 49.83, and of course you got your big round number at $50 a barrel, right? You're sitting right at that major top here right now. So not exactly the easiest place to get long on a shallow pullback. If you did want to get long in a shallow pullback, though, you'd have to focus on a trap entry, because traps are the most reliable entry setups whenever you're trying to avoid buying into resistance, right? And that's exactly what you're doing by buying that shallow pullback. I'm not going to say it can't happen, because anything is possible, especially in these markets these days. But just be aware, though, that is going to be a pattern that will have a lower probability here. What I'd rather do is get that nice move lower, get those bears coming over, give them a chance to try once, give them a chance to try twice. Once they get those two tries in, now we know where those stop losses are. We know the range overhead is a magnet. The buyers would love to go back and retest that high. What do we call these again? We call these nested failure patterns, right? Nested in this case, because there's two failures, right? The bears try once and fail. The bears try twice and fail. That's why I call them nested, right? Failures. Now, as you can imagine, right, this could also move lower, hold that pullback, and really jump off the moving average. This is one of my favorite ways to trade this. Now, I'd love to say we can buy that first pullback, but unfortunately, those pullbacks oftentimes fail, so I don't want to get too aggressive getting short on this. Remember, it's not a bear market right now, right? It's a bull market. Just like I talked about on the S&P, we have to give the buyers the benefit of the doubt. But if I can get this thing to 1, 2, 3 reversal, that takes the buyers out of commission, gives the bears control, and I can mark up that low, I can mark up that high, and I can look for that short, right, off of the high of that new channel. 1, 2, 3 reversal into a hidden channel pullback. Now, where would the target be here for those bears? Well, we have that big range, right, that we had from last night's newsletter. What's a range? Big old magnet right down there at $48 a barrel. That'll be an easy target for those sellers. And of course, if you got an extra contract left right in the position, 47.18 that low, and then down to those 46s, right, for the big move of the day tomorrow. As we talked about in last night's newsletter, they're making some changes at OPEC right now, so you do want to be aware there's potential for some big moves going lower here, or really big moves, right, in both directions here. Now, speaking of which, how would I buy this market as it goes higher? We have a pretty good plan of attack if the market pulls back for us right now. What would be the best way to buy this market? I'll tell you, we've really got to get a lot of strength on this market to want to be a buyer, because like I said earlier, if I measure that first leg and I project that leg here, this almost looks like a 5-wave Elliott wave pattern, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, where of course wave 1 and wave 5 are usually symmetrical. So we have to assume that 5069 area is going to be a key area of resistance. So I'm going to have to really be patient and wait for a strong breakout, a lot like on the S&P, right? I can't just buy up here, because there's just no proof these buyers are looking for more. So I would expect if we can get a strong breakout pattern, 5122 is likely where they're heading. In fact, if you look at this in terms of every once in a while, and if we're going back to that Elliott wave example, every once in a while, wave 3 is equal to wave 5. And so that 5122 swing, keep in mind, that's a big level of resistance overhead. That is the kind of when the whole pandemic began early last year, March, April last year, when oil completely fell apart, right? 5122 was the top of a big gap. If you go back to like a 4-hour chart or a daily chart, right, you'll see that 5122 and change up there. So again, we've got some big concerns about resistance overhead. But if I can get, you know, I'll tell you, if I could get, you know, a 1, 2, 3 move going higher, I wouldn't be afraid of grabbing that new channel, right, marking up that new hidden channel and grabbing that buy right off the low of that hidden channel. Or if we see a nice strong run higher, shallow pullback right to the moving average, higher high in price. Remember, these are easy patterns to spot because they have a lot of giveaways. Strong move up, shallow pullback, barely touches the moving average, higher high in price there, right, and that's not horizontal. There we go, right? That trap below that low. So that will definitely be that entry, right? That two try trap pattern that will also be on my radar as we go. But as you can see though, right? As you can see though, we've really got to get some strength up here. Now, could I sell this? Absolutely, I could. As the market tries to go higher, if we start to struggle around this measured move, the buyers are definitely going to be in control here. But what I can do is I can look for a one try for the bulls, two try for the bulls. I can look for a crown reversal short, right? Going back down where? Back into that range, because what is a range? A range is a magnet. I could also look for what is a little bit more common, and that is we try once for the buyers, we pull back lower, draw that trend line across, pop it up overhead. This is that same short setup we're talking about on the S&P. Again, is the trap above that high? That will be great, right? But I want a short up around some areas of resistance. What do we call these patterns again? We call these, well, they're failure patterns, right? Breakout failures. We call them nested failures because, well, after all, the market is bullish. So I want to give the buyers the benefit of the doubt. Let them try once, let them try twice, right? And I can sell short going back down again. Now, we see a lot of these patterns every day in our trade room. And don't forget, I cover all of them in that free trading course that I mentioned in the upper right hand corner. So grab that free course, like I mentioned, in the upper right hand corner, get registered. Now you can see a lot more examples of what these patterns actually look like. And don't forget too, guys, if you're on the YouTube channel right now, I'll put all of these important links, including a link to come out and join us every morning in our trade room sessions opening up at 8 o'clock Eastern time. I'd love to have you there, right there with us. You can learn more the description of this YouTube video, or I'll put a big button for you guys to click on below the video tonight on the trading block. So I think we got the oil pretty well put together right now, right? Oil looks pretty good. We got some good ideas for buy setups going higher. We got some pretty good ideas, right, for sell setups. Again, market is bullish, but we're at some major resistance. And as we rotate off these highs, I really got to respect that momentum for these bears. Looking good on the oil. Looking forward to a good session tomorrow on the oil. Shall we wrap things up now? On the gold, over to the final chart here tonight, the yellow metal, the gold futures. What's the key takeaway here on the gold for tomorrow? We had that big weekend gap we talked about in last night's newsletter. We are now 1, 2, and 3 legs higher here. Now remember, most trending markets are going to go 3 legs. Every once in a while, you'll see a market make a 4th, 5th, or 6th leg. But usually when a market goes 3 legs, usually we're going to start to see either a sideways range or a reversal. Now, again, there's always exceptions to every rule. We got an election going on right now, right? The runoff election. We got the electoral vote tomorrow on Capitol Hill. So gold is definitely something we're watching here in response to that. So there's potential, right? It may try to make a run up to that quadruple measured move, right? Which would be at this point up around that 64.7 and change, it looks like. But the reality though is we're definitely bullish, right? We can definitely tell that. And it looks like we've got a problem here with the range, right? We had a range in last night's newsletter. Market runs higher into that trading range. What do we get? We see a strong breakout. They come back and tap the range again, and they retest the high. So as far as I'm concerned, the buyers have control. The bulls got their breakout, but we don't have any proof. There's just no, there's no urgency. There's no open space above right now. And so this is kind of like oil, right? Where if we do rotate back down, right, below that range, I'll have to wait for one of those nested failures to buy back up. But honestly, I'd like to try to get short on this gold if at all possible, right? I know we're bullish right now, so I'm gonna have to make sure I respect the direction of the bulls, right, or the control of the bulls. But I'll tell you, I wouldn't mind here if we pull back, buyers try once, buyers try twice, again, call it a trap high with a crown reversal, draw that trend line across those lows, up around those highs. One of my favorite shorts, right, in a bull market. Again, we call these nested failure patterns. That would be a great setup to get short here for tomorrow. And then again, if we do end up rolling over here, right, I would love to see if I could get maybe a 1, 2, 3 reversal and grab that, right, grab that channel and get short off the top of that channel. My initial target is going to be down to the low of this battle zone at 1930. But however, as you can imagine, if this really starts to fall apart here, right, we may see this market really start to grow some legs, right, and tumble down, maybe not all the way to fill the weekend gap tomorrow, but that 1912, right, that is that prior big top up there. That would make a pretty easy target, right, for those bears. So again, looking kind of top heavy here for the bulls. I'd love to get short either with the 1, 2, 3 reversal pattern or a nested buyer failure, right? Buyers try once, buyers try twice, draw that trend line, pop it up there overhead. Can I get that trap, right? Can I get that trend line to come in and hold this resistance? That'd be a great one. Or that 1, 2, 3 reversal, right? And then pop that thing right off the top of that channel, right? Those would be some patterns I'm watching for, right, as we go. If for some reason the market collapses here and starts to run lower, I could look for that 2-try trap pattern, right? Strong move down, shallow pullback, right? 2-try trap, right? So if we do get that rolling over here, just make sure we don't chase it, right, as we go lower. Now, trying to go higher here. This is where things are going to have to get really good for these buyers. The buyers really have to show us some strength because, again, we're 3 legs up right now after that weekend gap on Monday morning. We know the big objective for these buyers is probably going to be this 1971.9. The next big level above that is the 2000 big round number. There's not a lot else up there to work with right now besides this quad measured move. So what you want to make sure you get here is you really want to get some strength as the market runs higher. So for example, if I can get a real strong run higher here right now, I can definitely ride the momentum of that move, because anytime we see a strong move in one direction, we know the odds are pretty good for a retest. I can mark up that high, I can mark up that low, and I can most likely be confident buying that first pullback. That's called, of course, a 1-2-3 breakout pattern, right, into a hidden channel pullback. At the same time, though, right, as we go higher here, let's say we run into that measured move up here. This is exactly the scenario where you start looking for those 1, those 2, right, those crown reversal patterns, right, off the high to get short, right, or that very reliable 1-2 mark those lows up around those highs, right, and off that hidden channel with those nested failures. So knowing where that level of resistance is overhead really makes it easy for us if we see this thing go up and immediately start to pull back here and struggle. That'll be a relatively easy short. And again, where's our target going to be on that? It's back down into that trading range. So we've really got to see a very strong punch, right, going higher here before we can really get confident to buy that pullback, because again, we're at that point 4 legs up, and so we definitely want to be careful. So waiting for a very strong breakout to confirm proof of that move up to 71.9. If we don't get it, we'll just keep shorting off that high using that range as we go. One more thing to keep in mind here for tomorrow: we get an election or the election today, but we'll probably, of course, have the same situation potential tomorrow with that electoral vote on Capitol Hill. If the market does end up going sideways here for a while, what that does is think of that as like a vote for the buyers, right? So if we do end up going sideways, what do we do in a sideways market? We find levels of support below the range, we wait for the price to pull back, we wait for those sellers to come in and try to get short off the pullback, and we look to buy into those stop losses. Remember, this is a very different situation than if we just pull back off the high, right? So if we do end up going sideways here, or let's say we go up into that quad, right, into that quad measured move, And that's where we start going higher, right? If we spend a good amount of time going higher up there, we find our levels of support below us, we wait for the price to pull back, and we use those, again, those seller failure patterns, right? Buying at support levels below the trading range, using the using a breakout pullback for the bears and buying into their stop losses. All right, guys? So I think it's the hardest part will be buying into these highs as we go, right? Either we're gonna see a strong break higher or a pop into a trading range to give us the confidence, right, to buy up high like that. And again, as I mentioned earlier, all of these patterns, you can learn a much deeper dive into them with that free trading course. Or come out and join me tomorrow morning in the trade room. You know, don't forget, tomorrow morning we open up, and every morning we open up at 8 o'clock Eastern time, and we'll be watching all these markets, right, getting ready for the best entry setups. Now, the easiest way to get registered for tomorrow morning's trade room, what I'll do is I'll put all the links you guys need for the free trading classes, right, to join our morning trading session at 8 o'clock Eastern time. I'll put all the links you guys need in the description of this YouTube video. So grab that link or hit that big button below me on the trading blog right now. Get registered for tomorrow morning's trading session, and hope I'll see you there, right there with us. If not, come back and see us again tomorrow night. We'll do it again tomorrow and look for the best setups for Thursday's trading session. As always, my name is Joseph. Thank you so much for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe. Drop those questions in the comment section below. And I hope by now I've earned a thumbs up here on the video. But until next time, as always, be well out there. Be nice to each other, will you? Stay healthy, by the way. I know things are going around right now. Stay healthy, stay happy, and we'll be here next time. Adios, amigos. Bye-bye for now.